So think this. Coffee in a can. It's not unlike to have coffee in the can, especially with that cold brew stuff. You go to the convenience store, you pop open the frozen set, not the frozen section. Now, you don't want frozen coffee.
No,
you pop open the fridge, and there it is. There's your cold brew. But think about getting it and then twisting the bottom, and your coffee heats up. There is a thing that actually works that does that.
It is a self-heating can, and it's from a company called High Brew Coffee. Never heard of it before. It almost looks like one of those energy drinks, but it's coffee. Look, it has no sugar in it. It is just straight black. It has extra caffeine in it and that kind of thing. Mm. But yeah, like Rob said, you take it and you twist the bottom of the can, and it heats up. So first question, how does it not burn your hand, and does it really get it hot?
It
or
says,
is it just sort of lukewarm?
2 minutes, it says it's hot. So I would like to try and see what it's like, especially if it has no sugar. I'm trying to do no sugar, although it's tough to do when I like cream in my coffee because sugar comes in cream. Hello, counterproductive.
Yeah, but it has no cream. It has no flavoring. It's literally just straight white coffee, which I don't like. But I like hot, hot coffee. If I order it, wherever I go, I always ask for it extra hot. And then when I get home, I put it in the microwave for another minute. So I like it scalding. I don't know if it can do that.
This brings up a totally different type of question about coffee.
Yeah.
I'm going to rabbit trail just a second here.
Okay.
Bear with me. Do you get rid of the coffee that's in your coffee pot if it's cold, or will you heat it up in the mic?
Because I'm cheap, fairly, I will heat it up, for a while.
Same. I do the same thing, but my wife will not do that. She's like, pour that out and just make new. And I'm like, no, it's coffee. I just heat it up in the mic. It's fine.
Right. It's just cold. It's not old. I mean, now if it sat there for a half a day, sure. But if it's just cold, yeah.
Okay. How long is too long? You say half a day, but what is half a day? An hour?
No, I would say a couple of hours, and I'd probably toss it.
See, I don't mind a couple of hours.
Yeah, I'd probably toss it after that because it gets super strong, and I'm not really into that either.
Okay.
His Morning Crew.
They came out with it. It's coffee in a can. You turned on the bottom of the can. It heats it up in 2 minutes. Coffee in a can that heats up like that. It's Robin Liz, His Morning Crew on His Radio, 800-447-7234.
Carol said, I make a pot before I go to work in the morning, have probably a cup, and when she comes back home 4+ hours later, she just heats it right up in the microwave.
That's what I'm talking about. That's exactly what I'm talking about. You heat it up in the microwave. I don't care how old it is. It's still the same day. It's still coffee. As long as the burner's not on and it burns the coffee, I think it's fine.
I think 4 hours, to me, is too long.
No. It's
a little dicey at that point.
You got to try it. Don't knock it until you try it.
Okay.
She's not going to do it. Daniel's along with us, 800-447-7234. What are your thoughts, Daniel?
If coffee sits more than 30 minutes, even in the coffee maker, I would not drink it.
Why?
It just tastes funny. I don't like it.
Would you use this heated can? Do you think it'd get it hot enough?
No, I would not.
Daniel's a purist.
Yeah, I guess. Thank you, guys.
Rob and Liz, His Morning Crew.
I feel so sorry for Tessica. Tessica had a problem that I think most of us have run into. You run out of your favorite hair product, and so you look around the house, okay, what else can I use? So she, instead of using the hairspray that she always uses to kind of keep her hair in place, and I think it's some false hair, maybe some extensions, she found Gorilla Glue instead of hairspray.
I'm telling you, revolutionized the way that you do your hair. The Gorilla Glue. Yeah.
You may never get to ever have another hairstyle again, but she used the Gorilla Glue on her head to keep her hair in place. She said she's washed her hair 15 times. It wouldn't move. Her hair would not move. It wouldn't come out. It would not move. And so she ended up having to go to the hospital, and they tried all different sorts of techniques. Finally, I think it did come out, but her hair was way damaged.
So correct me if I'm wrong. Didn't she like post all this? It became a trend and other people started using Gorilla Glue in their hair, thinking this is great. If she's doing it, I can do it. It's revolutionizing the way that I do my hair. It kind of stays there for a decade unless you get it washed out in the emergency room.
You have to go to the emergency room. Listen, Gorilla Glue is used for like decking.
Oh, yeah.
And flooring.
Wood, all that other stuff. It's called Gorilla Glue for a reason because it will stick and it's a cement, it seems like, you know?
I know, but don't use super glue. Don't use Gorilla Glue. But look, I've had hair mishaps before. One time I tried to go blonde, and I have very dark brunette hair. I tried to go blonde. A friend of mine said I look like the orb of the sun. I mean, it was just my daughter in kindergarten. I pulled up to pick her up. She wouldn't get in the car with me because she didn't recognize me.
That's great.
It was terrible.
Okay. Oh, whoa, okay. Hair mishaps. What was yours? You just learned about Liz. Gorilla Glue Lady, what about you?
Rob and Liz.
His Morning Crew.
I don't know if this happened to you, but Amanda said she got gum in her hair one time. It's Rob and Liz, His Morning Crew on His Radio. We're talking about hair mishaps because of that one lady that put Gorilla Gum in her hair. Gorilla glue in her hair and then had to go to the hospital to get it out. So here's Amanda. When she was a teenager, she had hair halfway down her back, got gum in it. She used peanut butter. So she put peanut butter on the gum. 30 minutes later, go to figure out, it worked and got the gum out.
Oh, yeah, and it does. It works. One of my kids put gum in another kid's hair, did the same thing. Put peanut butter in it, boom, it's out of there.
I never heard of that.
You really?
No, I never heard of that.
The oil in it, I guess, breaks down the gum. You know, take a bite of peanut butter, chew some gum at the same time, see how that works out.
I will this afternoon.
Okay. All right. Well, Brandy said, I don't want to call her out or anything, but about 20 years ago, I let my sister practice on me. She was in beauty school. It was a learning experience. I guess she tried to dye it. It turned orange. And she said, apparently my blonde hair has some strawberry in it. It was terrible.
That's awesome. You have to learn your lesson. Don't let your family practice on you.
Well, she said that her sister is now a hair stylist, and she lets her fix her hair all the time. So she's learned a lot.
She's probably the best right now. But when you're learning and it's dyeing your hair, man.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
You don't mix Gorilla Glue and your hair thinking it's a hair product. Somebody learned that lesson pretty quick. Had to go to the emergency room to get the Gorilla Glue out. It's Rob and Liz, His Morning Crew on His Radio.
Poor thing. I know. Lee texted in about her own hair mishap, and she said it was her daughter. They got her a perm back in the day when they were really in style. But the girl, because when you get a perm, you're really not supposed to shampoo your hair for a couple of days. She got paint in her hair the same day she got the perm. So what she did was use baby oil. Paint came right out, and she smelled really good, too, afterwards.
I'm sure after that smelled just like a baby.
I know. Mm-hmm. And then Joyce said for my 50th birthday, I wanted to get a new hairstyle, you know, really look great. So she went to the school where her friend's daughter was like a beauty teacher. So she had her best student color Joyce's hair. Bright red is the way it turned out, like a clown. And she had to walk around like that for about a week until it got fixed.
Oh, man. Ooh, that's the talk of the school. All that red hair like that, huh? We're hearing from Chris at 800-447-7234. This isn't about hair, but it is about glue. What happened, Chris?
One of our kids, he decided that he wanted to go ahead and dress up and have a costume to show off to his friends. Just before I ended up taking him to school, he's like, hey, Chris, do you have any super glue? I'm like, super glue for what? And he's like, well, the teacher, she's going to go ahead and do a project, and she needs super glue. I'm like, this is craziness. And I was really reluctant to give it to him because I was afraid that it was going to leak out into his pants and stick to his leg. So I ended up taking him over to school and get a phone call about 45 minutes later from his teacher. Yeah, we've got a problem here. Well, your son, he decided to go ahead and use some super glue and glue some teeth into his mouth to show off to his friends. And I'm like, oh, my gosh. So I ended up calling his mom. She took him over to the hospital, and the nurses just thought it was the funniest thing. They had never seen this before, and they're all taking selfies with him and just thought it was hilarious. And the only way that they could actually get the teeth out was to use a little bit of olive oil and butter to go ahead and get them loosened up and out. I'm just like, oh my gosh. It's definitely one of those things that you
Rob and Liz.
His morning crew.
I don't know if you saw her on social media, but here's this woman. She ran out of hair products. She thought, hey, I got Gorilla Glue. Let me do that. It'll keep it in place. Yeah, well, it kept it in place for days. She started to trend, and other people started to do the same thing. But then she came back a couple of days later and said, hey, I had to go to the hospital. Only the hospital could get this Gorilla Glue out of my hair. Yeah, my hair stayed on point for days. But I wanted a different style.
It's not supposed to be used for your hair. It's supposed to be used for decking.
Oh, man.
Okay, wait. We just got a text from Donna.
Uh-huh.
Donna said, 8 years ago, I convinced myself that I could cut my own hair with the proper guard on my clippers.
Uh-huh.
She shared a picture. It did not go well, in her own words. I will concur.
His morning crew.
His Radio is going to be doing something really cool with the My His Radio app. We call it Apptastic. It's Robin Liz on His Radio.
And it's going to be an Apptastic Valentine's. Here's what we have for your schmoopy, for your sweetie.
What did you say? For who?
For your schmoopy.
Schmoopy?
Yeah, I Joey doesn't like it.
No, neither do I. I'm with Joey. What's schmoopy?
He's like, stop calling me that. My schmoopy.
Hey, Joey, I got your back, dude. I don't like this schmoopy thing either. What's okay, that?
For your sweetie, we have a Bluetooth speaker. It's a His Radio Bluetooth speaker, which is pretty cool. We've also got a heart-shaped nuggy tray, which I love.
Here she goes, schmoopy and nuggy. What's Valentine's do to Liz?
Maybe. And then we also have a devotional for you, and we're going to put that all in like a prize pack, and you could win it, but you got to have my His Radio app to do it.
So coming up, let me see if I got the time right, 10:30 this morning. At 10:30 this morning, we're going to send you a little notification through the app that now is the time to sign up to win that. We'll have two winners every day, so there's going to be another one later on in the day, but we'll tell you the first one that's going to happen at 10:30.
His morning crew.
This is a restaurant in Pasadena, California. It's called Roscoe's. And evidently, their chicken and waffles is just the stuff. Because this guy goes in, unmasked. He wanted some chicken. And he felt like he needed to take an extra step to get it. Because they had an incredible deal going. It was like $10.49. And you got fries. And you got chicken. And you got gravy. So he had a bag. And he said, put the chicken in the bag. He didn't want money, like you said. He just wanted the chicken, the gravy, and the fries.
The detail that's being left out is he's robbing the place. But he's not robbing it for money. He's robbing it for the chicken meal.
Right. He just was like, put the chicken in the bag. He did have a weapon. And like, they didn't move. They just stood there because they were in shock, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he finally walks back to the cook station. And he said, give me the chicken. They put it in a bag. He took off.
Didn't take the money. He just wanted the chicken. He robbed the place for chicken.
Have you ever been, not that I would ever get to that point, but sometimes, you know, in the middle of the night or you're driving and you see that hot now sign, it's just like, come on, y'all, I gotta have it.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
When you hear this, you might think, no way is that going to ever happen. It's Rob and Liz, His Morning Crew on His Radio. So Demi's on social media. She's thought, I have a bobby pin. With this bobby pin, I'm going to be able to trade it and get a tiny house. I'm like, there is no way. And then I saw how she's doing this. And I'm like, okay, now that makes sense because she's doing this progressively. Like, for instance, she started with a bobby pin, and a bobby pin got her a pair of earrings. And from a pair of earrings, eventually got a vacuum cleaner, and it continues to go on.
Yeah, and she was inspired. The reason why she thought she could do it is a guy in Canada actually ended up doing this and ended up with a house. So that's what Demi is trying to do. She's trying to get herself up to that tiny house. So she eventually went from that vacuum cleaner that you mentioned to a snowboard, an Apple TV, even got a car. So she's closing in on what she intended to end up with.
So here's where she is now. She got that car, traded it in for a Peloton exercise bike, which those things are super expensive. So now she has herself an exercise bike, but her goal is, which is worth $2,200, she says. Mm-hmm. Her goal is she'll eventually trade that in for something, and then she'll keep trading up until she gets to her $9,500 goal, which is a tiny home. So evidently this is a thing. You're trading value for value, basically, or trading up. So she started with a bobby pin, got the earrings, worked her way up to this Peloton bike, and she thinks she trades that and she's just a few steps away from getting that tiny home that she wants.
And I wonder who's going to be that one, that person that trades to where she gets exactly what she wants. But I've got an idea. I've got this pair of scissors. Anybody going to trade me for something cool?
Oh, yeah, they will. Someone will do it. You can get a pair of earrings out of that. Maybe a coffee grinder, you know, so you can grind beans. That's worth a pair of scissors. You're going a little bit. You went too bad. You went too expensive there. I think a coffee grinder.
My expectations.
Yeah, yeah. You got to start small and work your way up. And it's only a trade. So this is a thing. I don't know. I would like one of those Pelotons. Maybe I can start with, I don't know.
What do you have?
I have a protein bar. Not eaten and out of the bag.
It is out of the wrapper, so I'm not so sure you can trade that.
I'll start with the protein bar.
Rob and Liz.
His morning crew.
Big chocolate Easter egg is coming out, and when you bite into it, it will be like an intergalactic surprise.
What? What happens? Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you're into Star Wars, specifically The Mandalorian, specifically the child, also known in certain circles as Baby Yoda, inside this chocolate Easter egg, marshmallow Baby Yoda.
I could not. I don't think I could eat him. I don't think I could do that. I just set him out on the counter and let him get hard so I could hold it forever.
You know what? I had a hard time with chocolate Easter bunnies growing up as a kid. I wouldn't eat them. I felt like I'm going to hurt the bunny.
Oh, that's so sweet and so innocent for a little kid to think that, because now you just, you know, rip the ears right off. And
true.
Yum, yum.
It wasn't until I was 13 that I decided I'm going to start with the ears.
Mornings with Rob and Liz.
Peter is an awesome guy. He's now a dad of a couple of kids, and I'll tell you how he became a dad of those children. See, Peter was a homeless 11-year-old in Uganda who was taken in when he was a couple of years older than that by a complete stranger, wanted to give him a better life. Well, you know, fast forward all these years, he now lives in America, and he knew that he had something to give back. He had love, he had a home, he had a lot of things to offer. He heard a story about a young man who'd been abandoned at a hospital in Charlotte. And he said, you know what? I'm going to take that kid in. That young man's name is Anthony. So what you also need to know about the story is that Peter is a black dad. Anthony is a white young man. And what Peter said is, in part, is that people need to notice, you know, they're going to notice that our family skin color is different. But what they need to notice is the joy, the love, and the connection that we share as a family, not just in our family, people need to notice that, but in all families. So he and his son, Anthony, started talking that they had enough love. They needed to bring some other kids into the mix. So now Peter and Anthony are fostering. So yeah, they're bringing more kids in to give them a home.
So if I understand this right, Peter's also single, right?
Yes, he is.
So he's a single dad. He took on in a teenager.
Yes.
And now they're fostering together. They're fostering some other kids as well. That is just so amazing. That's so much love to go around. And Peter understands, I mean, to be homeless in Uganda and then make his way to America and then adopt a teenager out of a hospital like that and to continue on sharing all of this love. He's opened up his home and he's making an impact. The guy is a world changer.
He really is. You talk about a world changer in the dictionary. You are right, Rob. That guy's picture's right there.
His morning crew.
Sadie is 6. And at 6 years old, Sadie, the German Shepherd, is already a hero. It's Rob and Liz, his morning crew on his radio.
Yeah, so Sadie's owner, Brian, he suffered a stroke. He was at home, had a stroke. Of course, he fell to the ground, probably passed out. Well, Sadie stayed with him, and not only did she stay with him, but she, like, licked his face to try to bring him around and then keep him awake, and then dragged him across the room to his cell phone. How did she know how to do that?
Smart girl. Sadie is just really smart, this German Shepherd. So that saved his life. He's in the hospital. The cool thing is now is that they have such a strong bond that there's not a night that goes by that he's not FaceTiming with Sadie. So he's talking to Sadie through FaceTime, and she's very attentive, and you can see all this, which is really cool. Another interesting thing about this, and it was just a couple of months ago that Brian actually adopted Sadie. So they've been together for a very short time, but their bond is so, so strong.
Brian saved her life, and then she saved his.